Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology, and I'm delighted to have Amanji with us once again. We have done a few recordings and people have been completely clean bowled by his explanations on nakshatras and remedies and so many other things which he will also share today. So please stay tuned, and he also has his own YouTube channel which is growing just like rocket. So please go and subscribe to it, and I will pin the link in the description section down below. And you also do consultations, so if you want your nakshatras to be analyzed and you want to know how the nakshatras will play around in your dashas and other different dasha systems also he uses. So please go to his website and get a reading done from him as soon as possible, all right? Because he's going to become much more busy in the future. I mean, he's already busy now. I don't know how much busy he will become later. All right, Swamanji, thank you very much for taking out time, and welcome to Exotic Astrology once again.
Thank you, Babaji ji.
It's all yours. You can share whatever you want.
Thank you. Thank you, Babaji ji. It's mera saho bhagya, aho bhagya ki you have invited me again. And I'm going to cherish this moment for my rest of my life. So thank you. Thank you. So let's start. I'm going to share my screen. Let me know when you can see my screen.
I can see everything, the screen and also what is inside.
Right. So today, this is a very, 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 very closest to my heart topic, nakshatras and Mother Nature. Because I get too many emails, too many buzzes, and people always ask me, you always talk about the Mother Nature. So what Mother Nature has to really offer, we're going to talk about that. We're going to connect some nakshatras with it. But before we do the presentation, there are some points I would like to mention. First of all, why I got attracted so deeply with the Mother Nature was, there was one particular video of my teacher, Dr. Arjun Pai, I saw. And after that video, the audacity, the zeal I had for the Mother Nature got 100 times more. And I was just thinking, like, what I can do in my capacity to take the understanding of what I have learned to another level, so that if I can do my two cents for the community or for the Mother Nature, maybe if a single soul, or maybe the 10 souls or the 100 souls can come forward and take this research or take this interpretation or take this learning or message, whatever they can interpret it, to the another level, I would be highly indebted to them. So it has been 1 year while I was thinking. So it is a very beautiful thing that why it is happening when Rahu entered Aradhra, because I was thinking to do a presentation on this from the last 1 year, but I never did it, or it never manifested it. So why it is happening Rahu in Aradhra? Because there were many reasons. Because first of all, the city I belong to, I think it has a lot of energy of Aradhra. And the another reason was, while I was doing the presentation, while I was making the bullet points for this presentation, I was thinking, I only have handful people of people in my community. So I was talking to myself and I was thinking, God or whatever the Lord or the Mother Nature around me, that I want to present this presentation to the masses. So how can I do that? While I was just thinking, or while I was just realizing it, your message came for the invitation on your channel. So this how the Mother Nature works. That's what I want to tell the audience. If you really connect, if the bhav, because the feeling only matters, if your bhav is pure, then the srishti gonna listen to you. So that's why it was necessary to give the background, like how things synchronize with beautifully with the nakshatras, and it does every time. And at this time also, when I was thinking how to connect with the masses, how I got the invitation, because I really wanted to present this presentation for the much bigger audience, so that the message goes out more deeply and more widely. So thank you, Babaji, for giving this opportunity, because it means a lot to me. Because if I have done the same thing on my channel, which I might, but the thing was my the community is not that big, but through you, I can reach out to many other people. So thank you for that. And before we start this presentation, there is another thing. I would like to bow down to the Mother Nature. I would like to bow down to all the souls and Pitris who are listening to us at this given moment. Shraddh is just started in India. So I bow down to them and I pray to them that they should do the justice to this presentation. And it's a very compressed version of 300 slides I have done. Here I'm going to only share, I think, 30-40 slides. And I think I have taken only a few nakshatras to relate with the Mother Nature, because it is a very big topic. So this is just the gist or the trailer or the teaser of the bigger picture. So I bow down to all the divine trees around us, the Kalpa Vriksha, all our Pitris, and all to my gurus and teachers, my family. It is just because of their grace I'm speaking right now in front of you. So we're going to talk about the nakshatras and Mother Nature. That's the very much the first slide on it. So this presentation, just like I was mentioning, it is inspired by my teacher, respected Dr. Arjun Pai sir. So, and I would like to dedicate this presentation to the Amazon fires, which happened, I think, a couple months back, and to the Mother Nature. So yes, this is a small attempt. Again, my two cents on it. So I will go by each word, even though they are very self-explanatory. So the aim of this presentation is to tell you guys the importance and significance of trees in our life, which is mentioned there in the Hindu scripture. So it is not what I'm going to say that I am saying this. Yes, I'm going to say it, but it is there in the Hindu scriptures, and I'm going to give you the source on each and every slide. So this presentation does not surpass the law of karma. So that is a generic thing. So don't think that you can surpass the law by taking the advantage of this presentation.
We'll change our karma.
No, I still remember, I keep getting the emails.
We'll change our horoscopes.
Yeah, I was about to say that. Like, there is nothing wrong with me, but something wrong with my chart.
I'm always perfect.
So I would like to give the credit to all the sources. I have taken the sources from 30-40 different websites.
Wow.
So I would like to give the credit to all of them, and especially to my better half, to the Lord Venus I have in my home, who have spent endless hours on this presentation with me. So it took me 2 months. So whatever you're going to see today, it took me 2 months, because I'm busy with my other stuff. I have other jobs. So a lot of efforts has been put in this presentation. And there is a disclaimer. This is based on my interpretation, and we respect everyone's opinion. So again, it is based on my opinion, and nowhere we are saying or nowhere we're going to claim this is the only correct version. So if you have different interpretation of it, we truly respect that from our heart. And again, I'm not a medical expert on Ayurveda. So if you want to take expert advice, always go to the medical expert or the Ayurveda doctors you have nearby. Okay, so let's start, Babaji ji. Mother Nature. So do we really understand what really she has to offer? When we say, try to connect with the mother nature, serve her, protect her, nurture her, we claim that, but do we really do that? Do we really connect with her? 90% of us, we don't. But yes, there are 10% of the people who really do. So on this slide, do you know the trees are one of the most important remedies available to us? And just like my teacher always says, all the Aushadhis, remedies are there in the Mother Nature. You don't need to go anywhere else. And again, I also have to say that I might use a little bit of Hindi here, because I think that's going to do the better justice with certain wordings. So bear with me, even though the full presentation going to be in the English side. So the significance of the trees has been documented in our Hindu scriptures. So whatever Hamari, Nani, Dadi, or maternal side, all the scriptures or the legend or the folk tales they used to tell us, have we ever thought that what is the mythology behind it? What is the logic behind it? What is the science behind it? Took the audacity to understand that? So we're going to talk about that. We're also going to relate the certain nakshatras with our olden scriptures. We're also going to do that. Because we all know we have 27 nakshatras that we are aware of. There might be many others, but we are only aware of 27 nakshatras. And each nakshatras comes with 27 trees and plants. So we're going to talk some of the nakshatras with that. And we're going to see the correlation with each tree shaktis working with each nakshatras. So this slide was again very self-explanatory. So our Vedas, our Purans and Upanishads all mentioning that. It is again not me or Babaji ji saying. It is our Upanishad saying, our Rig Veda saying, Yajur Veda saying, all the Puranas are saying. So we're going to take the references from their sources. So nothing I have made it from myself. It is I have taken from the different sources, from our Vedas and our scriptures. So this is the English version of the same tree. So these are the, Babaji ji, these are the general, some of the benefits which we get from the trees. Medicines, chemicals, canopies, shade.
Seems like everything you just said. it's like whatever is there in the earth is.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. So niswarth, unconditionally, they are only giving us, but what we are giving them back. All of us. And most importantly, I remember in one of the video, Sandeep ji said, most of the people, especially who are materialistic, we all are in some extent, we are all after moola. In Hindi, in money, we say moola. We all are after moola. So from where the moola comes? Again, from the trees. Yes, some of the countries now started doing plastic money. They are, our future is going towards the Ashlesha side of it. But still, a lot of countries are still using the paper mill. From where we get the paper? Again, from the bamboos, trees. So even the thing for most of us, we are going after. Again, we need the help of the trees. So this is the slide on that, that whatever you can think of, we are getting from the trees. We are getting from the Mother Nature's lap. So lot of fundamentals, lot of scriptures I have taken in this slide. So you have to bear with me. For some of them, it might be boring, but with you, I can totally relate. It will not be. So what does the scripture says about trees? And again, it's not me. It's the Matsya Puran saying, Daso Kupa Samavapi, Daso Vapi Samoharda, Daso Harda Samoputra, Daso Putra Samodhruma. So what that means in English, 10 walls is equal to a step wall. And this is a step wall of a Sarovar Sahib, of the spiritual places, step wall. So 10 step wells equal to a one lake, and 10 lakes equal to a sun, and 10 suns is equal to one tree. So one tree has the capacity to feed many families. So this what is written in the Matsya Purana. So the importance of trees, see, we can learn how important it is. So again, according to the Kurma Puran, Brahmaji created all the trees and plant from his dermal pores. Again, that's Kurma Puran saying. And these are the references in the Puran to sacred plants such as Bel, Peepar, Barkat, which are also considered as the holy trees, can be offered to various deities to various religious significances. That I'm pretty sure you are aware of it. Agni Puran says, also gives names of the plants that are used in the religious rituals that we are aware of. Most of us we are aware of. For those who are not, this is the slide for them, such as Bel, Mango, Neem. Vaman Puran says, this is very fascinating, Babaji Ji. The origin of the plants and the plant groups are associated with various deities. For example, what I mean by that? Palash plant is believed to have been originated from the right side of the Yama's body. That's what the Vaman Puran says. So a lot of fundamentals I have taken sources.